Sachin, should we start now?
Yes, Raj.
Sure. Let's have a huge round of virtual applause before starting. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Myself, Raj Bharat, Chief Strategist at Arms of first ever Timorous Speech Contest and Evolution Speech Contest of a Speakers Community Toastmasters Club of Division M District 98. Toastmasters Club has a mission which says that it provides positive and supportive learning experience in which every members are empowered to develop leadership skills and communication skills, which results in greater self-confidence and personal growth. Toastmasters International says that it empowers every individual to become a better leader and better communicator. With my best wishes to every role players, every contest officers, and every contestant, let's begin Humorous Speech Contest of a Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. But for conducting that, we have a special person. We have contest chair of Humorous Speech Contest, Toastmaster Hithi Agrawal. She is a chartered accountant by profession, specializing in taxation. She is fond of prose and poetry, with an aim to get over her fear of public speaking and what others think about her. She is eager to learn from the best in the Toastmasters community and on the Toastmasters platform. So, with huge round of applause, let's welcome contest chair of Humorous Speech Contest, Toastmaster Hithi Agrawal.
Thank you so much for that warm introduction, Toastmaster Raj. Greetings, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. Welcome to the Humorous Speech Contest of the Speakers Community Toastmasters Club, District 98, Division M, Area M3. Am I audible, visible, clearly? Okay. Thank you. A few ground rules before I start the contest. Please keep yourself on mute unless you are required to speak. Do keep your cameras on throughout the contest and avoid any unnecessary movements so that our speakers are not distracted. Feel free to appreciate and show your expressions of and express your gratitude or appreciation towards the contestants with the emojis in the bar below. Okay. So the Club Humorous Speech Contest provides an opportunity for speakers to improve their speaking abilities and recognize the value of humor in speaking, and for the audience to observe and learn from more proficient speakers. We had 8 listed contestants. However, due to personal emergencies, contestant number 7, Sharon, will not be participating today. I confirm all contestants are eligible, have been briefed about the rules, timings, and the display of timing signals. The chief judge has confirmed that the contest officials have been briefed. Our chief judge for today's humorous speech contest is Toastmaster Deepa Jilla.
Thank you, Vithi. Thank you so much.
Each contestant will deliver a humorous speech within a time limit of 5 to 7 minutes. After each contestant has spoken, a minute of silence shall be observed for the judges to mark their ballots. After the last contestant has spoken, 3 minutes of silence shall be observed for the judges to finalize the ballot and hand over their ballots to the tally counters. The speaking order was determined by random selection during the briefing, which has been shared with the contest officials. For the benefit of the audience, I am reiterating the contestant speaking order. Contestant number 1, Dheeraj. Contestant number 1, Dheeraj. Contestant number 2, Manas. Contestant number 2, Manas. Contestant number 3, Sai Kumar. Contestant number 3, Sai Kumar. Contestant number 4, Kalpana. Contestant number 4, Kalpana. Contestant number 5, Aarti. Contestant number 5, Aarti. Contestant number 6, Shreya. Contestant number 6, Shreya. Contestant number 8, Pranjali. Contestant number 8, Pranjali. I reiterate, contestant number 7, Sharon, will not be participating today. So judges, please refrain from marking anything against her name. May I remind you again to keep your audios on mute and the videos turned on throughout the contest. Chief Judge Toastmaster Deepa, please confirm if all the contest officials are in the room and we may begin the contest.
Yes, contest Avriti. All the officials are in the room and we can begin the contest.
Thank you, Chief Judge. Zoom Master, please spotlight contestant number one. Thank you. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I'm excited to participate in this contest.
I'm excited to participate in this contest.
You're audible and visible. Please ensure that you have pinned timer one to see the timer cards and confirm.
Yes, ma'am.
Timer, please flip the cards. Are the timer cards visible? Are you ready to go?
Yes.
Okay. Contestant number one, Dheeraj. The emotions of a student. The emotions of a student, Dheeraj.
As a student, whenever I offer my prayers to the God, this complicated derivation should not come in the exam. The next day, on the front page of the paper, the derivation was there and that too of 20 marks. When I requested to the God, today maths teacher should not check the homework. On that day, maths teacher only checked the homework and I was the first person to begin. I offered my prayers to the God, I should not be the first contestant. And now you all can see, I am the first contestant. I don't know why in a troubled situation, I automatically become the number one. With this, I welcome the contest chair, fellow Toastmaster and the guests. Welcome to the contest session of Speakers Community Toastmaster. I have always been a bold, strong, never cry guy, and the common trait which is available in all the backbenchers. But today I will be cry and I will be emotional if you all don't laugh at my speech. We all have experienced two contradictory teachers in our school days. One is our maths teacher, ugly, strict, no emotion, cruel. And on the other hand, we have Miss Rosie, sweet, beautiful, gorgeous, adorable, magnanimous, so on, our English teacher. The name of both the teacher clearly depicts about their personality. Miss Rosie, sweet and beautiful like a rose. And my maths teacher, Iqbal Ahmed. Iqbal, he had just one hair left on his head. Whenever I did something notorious, Miss Rosie was like, Dheeraj, be a gentleman, Dheeraj. Tuck your shirt in, Dheeraj. Roll down your collar, Dheeraj. She never beats any student. At the most, she will shout out at the class and say, I've never seen such a class in my whole life. And she repeats this statement every year in all the classes. If the student still does not calm down, she will use her Brahmastra. She will call the PT teacher, the strongest weapon of her against all the students. I used to like Miss Rosie and I attended all her class attentively. But still, I didn't improve my English. There I understand the importance of focus. Actually, in English class, I learned about different hairstyles and mascara. Now come back to my maths teacher. Tell me honestly, how many of you have seen that the teacher uses wooden scale for drawing a line? Never. If a teacher never uses the wooden scale for drawing a line. And because of this wooden scale, me and all my backbenchers learned Gabra during the school days. Whenever my maths teacher used to hit us, I'm like. So during the school days, we all learned the Gabra, we all particularly the backbenchers. One day, after accomplishing one of the major milestones, one of the mischievous activity, I was dancing on the table of my classroom. Suddenly, Miss Rosie came in. And we know a typical behavior of an English literature teacher. Dheeraj, come down, Dheeraj, Dheeraj, come down. And suddenly, after her, maths teacher also entered into the classroom. And we all know that how a male teacher behaves when there is a female teacher in that class. Maths teacher called me. Dheeraj, come down, Dheeraj. I will teach you how to dance on the table in the class. And I reached near to him. He asked me to remove the glasses. And then, And for the next few days, Dheeraj Singh will be like Dharmatma Singh. This incident and several such incidents made such an impression in my mind. And even today, when I visit my senior colleagues, I remove my glasses. Have any of you ever wondered that why I always keep small ears? The reason being my math teacher. Whenever I disobey him, he is like, "Padhe, come in, padhe." He will never be sincere with the studies. And the amazing fact is that I am 6'1" and my math teacher is 5'2". And that does not stop him from doing this thing. He will arrange a stool, stand on the stool, and then jalebi bhai. In my neighborhood, there's still a gentleman, 45 to 46 years of age. He is very smart guy. But he also keeps a small guy. Out of curiosity, I asked him that, why you keep such a small guy? You're such a handsome guy. He told me, he narrated me a story. And the conclusion is, my math teacher is similar to his wife. And the takeaway from this speech is, if you have a dominant girlfriend or a wife, don't keep long hair. Nobody tells the truth. But people will blame that stress and aging is the reason. But the actual reason is this. I remember one of the incidents which was commonly found in all the schools in India. That if you are a guy and you ask for going to toilet in the math class, the teacher will not allow you. You have to plead like your father has taken a loan from him and unable to repay him. Sir, please, sir, allow me, sir, come on, sir. I am about to plead. But he will not listen to it. But if a girl just stand up, he said, "Hey, don't worry, be comfortable. Take Neha along with you. Go to the canteen, have some breakfast. Come to me later on and I will explain everything." And this is the damn reason that majority of the students and majority of the boys and go out of the classroom, they go and pee anywhere on the road and on the corners. Now comes the doomsday. The doomsday for all the backbenchers, the day of maths exam. When I got the paper, I was a little bit frustrated and troubled. When I look back at my mathematics teacher, Iqbal sir, I can see the evil smile on his face. He was feeling so satisfied. We backbenchers also feel low for some time. I kept my head down. And again, I look back at 45 degree angle. There stood, was sitting a small, beautiful girl, Sakshi. She was topper from last 4 years. Last year, she secured 96 in maths. I also secured 96, but to reach to that number, I have to add all my 7 subjects mark. But one thing was clear between me and my backbencher friends and with the teacher. That what they teach, I don't understand, and what I write, they don't understand. All out of this, I was imagining everything that how I would play. I again looked back at Sakshi, the topper. She was using map of India. Who requires the map of India in the mathematics exam? I took my paper and again wrote down everything. And even I am provided with the map of India. But I could not figure out how to use the map of India and which question requires the map of India. And I was certain that I am going to fail. So fail with the 0 marks or fail with the 90 marks. Similar thing, why to put the point? When I kept back my paper and looked at the front page of the paper, it was geography and the exam. Thank you. Over to you.
We will now observe a 1 minute silence to allow the judges to mark their ballots. One minute is up. Zoom master, please spotlight contestant number 2. Thank you. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I'm excited to participate in this contest.
I am excited to participate in this contest.
You are audible and visible. Kindly ensure timer 1 is pinned to see the timer cards.
Yes.
Thank you and all the best. Contestant number 2, Manas, husband and wife. Husband and wife, Manas.
Hey Manas, are you mad? How can you participate in this humor speech contest? Only 2 days left and you still were not prepared your speech. Hold baby, chill. You just enjoy the contest. I am there for you to prepare the speech. This was the altercation between my two minds, who always act like a husband and wife. And I am the person who stared to both and thinking who won this love and war. Good morning to contestants, chair and fellow Toastmaster and guest. I will take you on flight mode with one common person's uncommon story, which disturbing a lot. Hold the progress of entire world's economy. Responsible for this petrol hike. And maybe it is the only reason for this COVID-19. But do you know why I say good morning at this afternoon? No, it is not the reason for all this incident and accident, what you are thinking. It is the reason that, you know, this world only gives a smile on my baby's face. It is the only world which make my baby. And with this, I can see a new hope in my baby's eye. Let me ask you a question, one straightforward question. Do not scare if your partners are with you. How you remember your wedding day? Is this the day was your last day of your bachelor life? Or it is the day you are remembering when your partner reminds you? Or on this day, you just started off just like a lovable bird and ended husband and wife. I remember this day as I met my soulmate, who holds my hand, shows me the path to walk, always inquiring whether I had my lunch or not, with whom I took my lunch, what I am doing when she was talking to me. I always remember my wedding day in all these moments. 2 days back only, my baby held me. Baby could this contest. Otherwise, you will be an object of ridicule in this humor speech contest, as you have not prepared your speech yet. Do you know Ankit? Ankit mentioned now, people are quitting at last moment also. Do not try to be over smart. Quit now, as still 2 days are left. I do not want to be offended in my friend circle for your this stunt. Yes, baby, you are right. But didn't you heard Ankit now? He told now that Manas, 2 days are there. You can do it. Do not quit. I have to participate, my baby. I cannot take my step back. You will have heard many words of advice in the past. When the secret of marriage were spoken, but you know that the answer lies hidden inside, where the bond of true love lies unbroken. Wife and husbands are good friends, like Tom and Jerry. To protect Jerry, Tom always pretend to hit and chase her in front of his owner. I am feeling the same situation when my two minds were chasing with each other in front of me. My headlights are just anxiously watching to know who wins, to whom I need to follow. They are like two tires of my two-wheeler. If one punctures, my vehicle can't move further. Yes, friends, this is the uncommon story of common person who knows everything but do not do. Knowing is knowing, doing is doing. Everyone is know, and everyone cannot do all the things. And this is the only reason for marriage broken to country separation. Gold medal in Olympic to COVID-19. And this is the main reason that 97% people have 3% of wealth and 3% of people have 97% wealth. Everyone struggling to be with one mind. Always watching who wins. Wherever rain, there is an umbrella. I am one of the common person. I born in one independence country. How can I be a slave of my own mind? No, it's enough. I have to take the remote control on my hand. What do you think about it? Thank you.
We shall now observe a minute's silence to enable the judges to mark their ballots. One minute is now up. Zoom master, please spotlight contestant number 3. Thank you. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I am excited to participate in this contest.
I am excited to participate in this contest.
You are audible and visible. Please confirm if you can see the timer cards. Timer, please flip the cards.
Yes.
Okay. Are you ready? Contestant number 3, Sai Kumar. It's never too late. It's never too late, Sai Kumar.
Oh my God. It's not fitting me. It's too late, my dear contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and all my put-on guests. I am feeling irritated because of this X factor. Whenever I wear this, it appears like a big hippopotamus walking alone in the forest. Instead of decreasing, the X factor in me increased so rapidly that even I could not recognize myself. The X factor is like a rubber ball. The less you stretch, the more it will expand. Believe me, in a very short span of time, it kept on adding one more letter. X to XL, XL to double XL, double XL to triple XL. The X factor in me is my big fat belly. And I am the victim of this X factor. My entire clothes are not fitting me. I feel Is it my own clothes which I was wearing few months ago? Now this has become a big tire which will burst at any time. When I see in the mirror, I think, is it me or a big giant creature? A replica of Adnan Sami standing and singing, "Ye zameen phat jaye, this earth will break into pieces." More importantly, when I post my recent photos in matrimonial site shadi.com, I expect first question girl will ask, "What is your present salary package?" But I get a question something out of the blue, out of my imagination. They ask, "What is your current weight?" Now if I type my weight is --, immediately within 10 seconds I receive a very beautiful and weird message. The user has filtered you out permanently. They filtered me out saying you are not eligible as per the weight category. First, go and build 6-pack and then come and plan for a family pack. You have gained weight, so you have to wait. All my excitement and curiosity to find a girl went in vain. I decided to do something extraordinary before all girls start to filter me and I remain an eligible bachelor. I decided to wake up 5 a.m. in the morning, set an alarm clock of 5 a.m. In the morning, when the alarm clock rang, in a lazy mood, I said, "Let's sleep today and start workout tomorrow." Next day morning, again when the alarm clock rang, once again I said, "Let's sleep today and start our work tomorrow." And this continued on and on. There came a situation where I was not able to sit and stand. I need to take immediate action before four-letter word L-A-T-E is added before my initial. No more excuses. I started to wake up 5 a.m. in the morning, do my workout for 1 hour, avoided all the junk food. With proper diet and plan, I have reduced 4 kgs in less than 3 months of time. Now my overall health and stamina is getting better and better. I'm really enjoying this routine. In gymnasium, I do weight training to develop 5 muscles. Bicep, tricep, shoulder, back, chest. But during the course of training, I also developed 2 more muscles. Muscle E. The energy which remains with me throughout the day. I feel as young and fresh like Shah Rukh. The muscle C. The confidence in me has boosted up. Now I confidently sing, "Mujhko bhi to lift kara de, please lift me up." Now all my formals are fitting me slowly and slowly. So my dear friends, if you are the victim of such X factor, And if you see the replica of Adnan Sami or comedian Bharti in you, do not worry. It's never too late. Do this, this, and this. Because it's never too late to lose weight. Am I right, my fitness chair? Let me ask my contest chair. Thank you.
We shall now observe a minute's silence to enable the judges to mark their ballots. One minute is now up. Zoom master, please spotlight contestant number four. Thank you. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I'm excited to participate in this contest.
I am excited to be a part of this contest.
You are audible and visible.
Thank you.
Please confirm if the timer cards are visible. Timer, please flip the cards.
Yes, they are.
Thank you. Contestant number four, Kalpana. Name and identity. Name and identity, Kalpana.
What are you called? In the four walls of your homes. Puttu, Bittu, Mintu, Chintu, Muntu, Mono. Patki, Ladli, Chutki. Pari, Sunpari, Gudiya, Gutti. Good evening, contest chair, fellow toastmasters and guests. Since I was a tiny bundle of joy passing from hand to hand, I was called names, apple of my eye, apple tart, smelly cat, whenever I get chichi. I think our Christian names just remain on our birth certificates, ID cards, insurance papers, and when we go to parents' papers. It was only when I entered kindergarten I realized my name was Kalpana. And I was happy I would be called by that name. But no such chance. Bullies name you according to your physical and mental dimensions. If you are tall, you're a telephone pole. If you're short, you're a dwarf. If you are fat, you're a hamburger. And if you are lean and thin, you're a bamboo stick. If your IQ is more than 160, you are dyslexic Einstein. And if you happen to be beautiful, they call you Marilyn Monroe. That perhaps as a compliment. But woe begone if you are a teacher's pet. You will hear it throughout your school life, through the corridors. Oh, how is the teacher's pet? You want to escape these nicknames. I used to go home and complain to my mom, who only had one line. My dear, Shakespeare has written, what's there in a name? To me, there is everything in a name. I came to college and I told everyone I'm Kalpana. And I remained Kalpana. And I remained Kalpana. Till my first mall movie with someone that I wanted to make my date, I began to do a makeup on my identity. Slim and trim, I walked down the mall. Suddenly I was attacked by a random neighboring auntie. Oh, golu, 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 katlo. Oh my God, look at you. Before I could even react to it, somehow managing to get rid of this golu golu auntie away from my nickname, I got a slap on my shoulder from behind and heard a sound. Oh, 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 oh. How is the teacher's pet dog? I had enough. The alphabet of my name crashed and shattered on the ground. I reached home. One glance at me, my mom knew what was wrong. She told me, I said, don't talk about Shakespeare. Not at all. Nicknames are endearments. Amitabh Bachchan is known as Lamboji. Shah Rukh Khan is known as Hakla. And you know what? Rajesh Khanna was known as Kaka. Well, don't you forget about Kareena Kapoor. She is Bebo. Karishma Kapoor is Lolo. And the recent Ray Valia Bhatt. She, you know, is Alu. I just read about it. Mom, seriously. Oh, come on. What difference does it make what a rose smells like? She began in a random way the Shakespearean quote. And I said to my mom, if Miss Rose was there, she would have whacked Shakespeare and told him, please don't mess with my name. I decided to take an inventory of the European names. And guess what? These names? Ah, they were just name and a number. Let me tell you, the royalty. Queen Victoria, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Queen Elizabeth, 19, 11, 12. King Louis, 13, 14, 18. They just go on. There is nothing but a name and a number. Oh my God. And then I realized the common names, don't talk about it. I'm Tom. This is my father, Tom. This is my son, Tom. Hello, I'm Victoria. This is my mom, Victoria. This is my daughter, Victoria. No imagination where the names are concerned. Yes, they have started to have some weird names like India, Apple, and Elon Musk has named. Can you read it? No. Believe me, one of my cousins had visited US, Chirag Shah. They called him Chirag Shah. His name not Chirag Shah and Chirag Shah. Well, Indian names are difficult. Can we call you Charles? No, he said. You are Jackson, right? Yes, Jackson. Can I call you Jaikishan? No, don't mess with my name. Exactly. Don't mess with my name too. Fellow Toastmasters, name is an identity. Never let anyone mess with your names. What? Ah, nicknames. Believe me, nicknames, as my mother just said, she's very wise. She told you, nicknames are endearments. People call you something lovingly. They become memories. So, your name is your identity. Signed off by Kallu, alias Kalpu, alias Caps, alias Kalpna. Thank you. Over to you, contestant.
Now we should observe a minute's silence to enable the judges to mark their ballot. One minute is up. Thank you, Zoom Master, for spotlighting contestant number 5. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I'm excited to participate in this contest.
I am excited to participate in this contest.
You are audible and visible. Kindly confirm if you can see the timer cards.
Yes.
Okay. Contestant number 5, Aarti. The balance, Aarti.
Balance is not something you find. It's something you create. Balance is a feeling derived from being whole and complete, a sense of harmony. But have you ever seen a vehicle with one wheel that of a tractor and the other wheel that of a scooter? And then also, it's running smoothly on the path of life. A great humorous evening, chief judge, contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and guests. If there is anybody here who is feeling nervous, worried, or apprehensive, you are either me or you just married. I know you all must have played a video game. What do you feel in the beginning? In the beginning you feel, oh, it's so easy. But slowly and steadily, it becomes harder. And then it becomes difficult to crack. Marriages and video games are more or less same. They say marriages are made in heaven. Then I wonder where the divorces are made. In the courtrooms or in the drawing rooms of a home? Let me take you to a tour of my childhood memories. I am an audio and video player in my joint family. I observed everything. My elder uncle, Kirit uncle, and my auntie, Kirti auntie, loved me a lot. So I used to play in their room. One fine morning, I was playing in their room and reciting, "Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are." Suddenly, they entered into my room and they started talking. You know, our neighbor, Rasik Bhai, he gives golden ornament to his wife on occasions. And if I say, "You don't give," why should I give golden ornaments to Rasila Ben, Mrs. Rasila? But you know, if you say, and you have no problem, I can give a golden ring to her. You know, she likes me a lot. She was flirting with me when there was a party last night. I could not understand why my auntie was angry on that day. Before marriage, you promised me that you will treat me like a queen. Oh, darling, I will, but let me be the king first. Before marriage, you told me you will bring stars from the sky for me. But I know you are not going to bring it. But can you bring one 5-star today? Before marriage, you told me that I am your dream girl. But last night I heard you were murmuring something. "Sapna, Sapna, who is this Sapna?" Oh, darling. Today, you are my wife. I cannot dream the same dream always. So I have kept your name Sapna in the dream, you know? So don't worry. You are my wife. You are my darling. My aunt became angry and went away. Now, uncle realized that he was getting late for his bath. So he shouted and told my aunt, "Kirti, Kirti, bring hot water." As aunt was angry, "If I won't give you hot water, then what will you do?" "Oh, darling, I will bath with cold water only. You don't worry." That day, my uncle never a bathroom singer. Just like Sanjeev Kumar in a song, thande thande pani se nahana chahiye. We should bath with cold water, cold, cold water. And he became a bathroom singer on that day. That day, I learned a lesson that if one partner is angry, then other should keep mum. Let me share you one of my recent incident. It was 15th September 2021. There was my speech and I was preparing for that. I told my husband that please listen my speech. He said no. I said you will have to listen to my speech. He said how he tricked me, you know. He told me that, okay, I will listen to your speech, but that will be my birthday gift to you from me on your birthday. Oh, but I happily agreed that, because nowadays my priorities has changed. I have come across many couples who are quite different in their choices, personality, and nature, but yet they get along very well. There should be harmony and balance in a married life. Then only one will that of a tractor and the other will that of a scooter can run smoothly on the path of life. No one is perfect. To live happily, we all have to make compromises and adjustments. If all husbands and wives understand that, there will only be home, sweet home, and no place for divorces. What's your opinion, contest chair? Thank you. Over to you.
We shall now observe a minute's silence to enable the judges to mark their ballots. One minute is now up. Thank you, Zoom Master, for spotlighting contestant number 6. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I'm excited to participate in this contest.
I am super excited to participate in this contest.
You are audible and visible. Kindly confirm if the timer cards are visible to you.
Yes.
Thank you. Contestant number 6, Shreya. My new normal. My new normal, Shreya. We shall now observe a minute's silence to enable the judges to mark the ballots. One minute is now up. Thank you, Zoom Master, for spotlighting contestant number 8. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I am excited to participate in this contest. Contestant number 8, are we audible? Contestant number 8, are we audible?
Yes.
Okay. To check your audio and video, please repeat after me. I am excited to participate in this contest.
I am excited to participate in this contest.
Thank you. Please confirm if you can see the timer cards. Please ensure timer 1 has been pinned.
I'm not able to pin. Just one minute.
Can you please enable the speaker view?
Anyways, I'm okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Contestant number 8, Pranjali. Consumer is the king. Consumer is the king, Pranjali.
It was a Sunday afternoon. I was doing my regular ritual of feeding my son, 5 years old, and he was staring at the television screen. Suddenly, he saw an ad with his favorite cricketer. Boost is the secret of my energy. My son looked at me and asked, Mom, if it is a secret, how they are telling on the television? I was astonished with his question. My jaws dropped. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and judges. I'm Pranjali. And I welcome you all to this world of fast-moving consumer goods. And we all are the kings here. This incident of 5 was sitting on the floor and watching our favorite show, Chitrahar. Suddenly, an ad came. Jo biwi se kare pyar, वो प्रेस्टीज से कैसे करे इनकार? My mom's harsh look. My mom was staring angrily towards my dad. My dad was embarrassed and he took a short water break. We knew it was an unnecessary water break. We understood, being kids, that my father was not among those prestigious husbands certified by Prestige Pressure Cooker that they love their wives and to escape from the situation, he just went away. It also reminded me of one character. She was a 40-45 year lady who used to visit our place very frequently. She was having slightly gray hair. I used to wish her very smartly, "Hello, auntie." She used to get embarrassed on me. "Don't call me auntie. Auntie mat kaho na." She used to complain to my mother and the complaint was to be taken very seriously. Now I understand she has taken one ad of hair color very seriously and she didn't want anybody to call her auntie. She was 45 but used to look 25 and she wanted to remain like that. You won't believe. She used to even today, I call her Didi. I don't dare to call her auntie.
having silvery, silky hair all over her head, but still no auntie. My daughter shook me. Mama, mama, mama. What happened? I returned from the flashback. My daughter asked, Mom, can we change our edible oil? Why? She was pointing towards the ad of having a dancer who was eating 10 samosas, then going on the stage and dancing, floating like a feather. Now I understood. My 5 feet, 60 kg daughter wanted me to change the edible oil so that she can float like a feather. I understand. Suddenly my maid shouted from the bathroom, Didi, domic khatam ho gaya hai. Main floor kaise pochu? I understand. So I had to rush today to get some important things for the house. Dishwash cleaner, floor cleaner, all those type of stuff. So I got ready and wanted to go to the mall. Now the kids, they won't stay at home. They want to accompany, want to go to the market. Okay, we all three got together and went to the mall. It was a grocery mall having many varieties of things. We shopped and shopped for 3-4 hours. And here I was standing in the queue with the list of bill. Bill was worth 14,000 rupees. I was surprised. I came here to take the dishwash bar and the floor cleaner. And now the list. Oh God, what stuff we have picked up. Stuffs having 50% discount, 1+1 free, 2+3 free. And all those diet stuffs, diet coke, diet snacks and whatnot, whatnot. Anyways, with the heavy heart, I paid the bill and came back home. Returning, driving, I was thinking that these advertisers have done great minute R&D on our mentality. They know we take all decisions from the bottom of our heart with our subconscious mind always awake. And that subconscious mind is governed by the advertisements. They grab our attention and they make us shop. This is how we do the shopping. And my fellow Toastmasters and the chair, please, please think about it and save your pockets. You are the kings, but somebody is robbing your treasures unknowingly. You don't know where the treasure is going. Thank you. And over to you.
We shall now observe a 3 minutes silence to enable the judges to finalize their ballots and hand them over to the tally counters. 3 minutes are up. Chief Judge, please confirm if we may transfer you and the tally counters to the breakout room.
Hello. Yes, Vrithi, you can shift us to the breakout room. Me and the 3 tally counters.
Thank you, Chief Judge. Zoom Master, please open the breakout room and confirm once the Chief Judge and tally counters have been shifted.
Yes, they all have shifted to the breakout room.
Thank you, Zoom Master. And with that, we are going to be holding back the results till the end of the contest after the evaluation speech contest coming up. I now hand back the stage to our Chief Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Raj. Over to you.
So much, Contest Chair of Humorous Speech Contest, Toastmaster Vrithi. You did so fabulously hosted the contest. Now we will have a 5 minute bio break. Then we will begin the evaluation speech contest at 4:15. So kindly do not leave the meeting, stay with us. Thank you.
Hello. Hello. Is there anybody who wants to do a audio check?
Yes, Subbu, I would like to do it.
Yes. Please go ahead, Kit.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. This time, let's begin evaluation speech contest of a Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. For this to host, we have Contest Chair Subramaniam Srinivasan with us. He is a Toastmaster since over 5 years and a part of a corporate club called Silver Tongue Toastmasters Club, Chennai. He loves to mentor and wish to make a difference in others' life. Toastmasters gives a platform to achieve his intent. With huge round of applause, let's welcome Contest Chair of Evaluation Speech Contest, Toastmaster Subramaniam Srinivasan.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Raj, for that warm and kind introduction. I feel privileged to be the Contest Chair for this Evaluation Speech Contest. Good afternoon, District Officers, Chief Judge, Distinguished Toastmaster Atul Srivastava, Contest Officials, Fellow Toastmasters and Guests. A very warm welcome to each one of you to the Speech Evaluation Contest of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club of Area 3, Division M, District 98. The purpose of the evaluation contest is to encourage development of evaluation skills and to recognize the best as an encouragement to all. To provide an opportunity to learn by observing the more proficient evaluators who have benefited from their Toastmasters training. Let's go over the rules. It has been confirmed that all the contestants are eligible and have been briefed. At the beginning of the contest, a 5 to 7 minutes test speech will be presented. Contestants can make notes during the test speech on a plain sheet of paper. At the conclusion of the test speech, all the contestants will be moved to the breakout room. They will get 5 minutes to prepare, organize their evaluation. After 5 minutes have elapsed, we will begin the contest with contestant number one, whilst the other contestant remains in the breakout room with a sergeant at arms, and they will later be invited into the main room as per their speaking order. Timing will begin with the contestant's first definite verbal or non-verbal communication with the audience. The time allotted is 2 to 3 minutes. There will be a grace period of 30 seconds. Speaker speaking for less than 1 minute 30 seconds or more than 3 minute 30 seconds will be disqualified. The green card will be displayed at 2 minutes and will remain displayed for 30 seconds. The yellow card will be displayed at 2 minutes 30 seconds and will remain displayed for 30 seconds. The red card will be displayed at 3 minutes and will remain displayed until the evaluation has concluded. No signal will be given for the overtime period. In case of a fault in the timing device, an additional 30 seconds will be allowed for the speaker. There will be a 1 minute of silence that will be maintained between speeches for the judges to mark their ballots. After all contestants have finished their speeches, a 3 minutes of silence will be maintained to enable the judges to total their scores and hand over their ballots to the ballot counters. The speaking order of the contestants have been determined and shared with the chief judge. For the benefit of audience, roll takers, I will announce the speaking order. Please note, our contestant number one, Sharon, is unavailable to attend this contest. Hence, there are only 4 contestants. I would request all the role players and contest officials to make a note of this. Contestant number two, Manas. Contestant number two, Manas. Contestant number three, Sai Kumar. Contestant number three, Sai Kumar. Contestant number four, Kalpana. Contestant number four, Kalpana. Contestant number five, Ankit. Contestant number five, Ankit. I will call the contestants as contestant number and then mention the contestants' names twice. Timers, please check your timing device one last time. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. I think you can share your. Yes. Thank you, Arjun. Thank you. Request all the audience to stay on mute and keep your video switched off. Chief Judge, are all the officials in the room and have they been briefed?
Yes. So yes. Everybody has been briefed as required. They are all available and you may begin the contest further.
Thank you so much, Chief Judge, for confirming. Let me invite our test speaker. Just a note to the timer, this is 5 to 7 minute speech. Our test speaker today is Madhu Kaimal. May I please have him on spotlight? Okay. Madhu, to do an audio video check, kindly repeat after me, test speech 1, 2, 3.
Test speech 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Thank you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Toastmaster Madhu Kaimal, striving for the action, not the position. Striving for the action, not the position, Toastmaster Madhu Kaimal.
Thank you, Toastmaster Subramaniam. So I'm going to speak a little bit about different styles of leadership. Let me go back to the days when I just joined the corporate world. During the first few weeks, I used to think, why is my manager or my boss given so much attention? Why is he paid so much? Because I used to think what I do and what my manager does is more or less the same. Then why is there so much delta? I know, as naive as it sounds, I was very new to the corporate world. I dug deeper into the corporate world and I learned the importance of a leader. I've had my own fair share of good leaders and bad leaders. There were leaders who single-handedly brought down the entire project down to the drain because they were not great. And there were also leaders to whom I reported to who single-handedly hoisted the entire project to a level where no one could achieve, could reach. And that's how I know that this guy is a good leader and this person is a bad leader. Having said that, from my experience, I feel there are certain objectives that a leader should have, which are first and the most important, and this is very obvious. The leader should be able to achieve the company and overall goals. That is, that it may be the revenue targets, it may be the client satisfaction, it may be customer satisfaction, whatever it may be. That is his or her first priority. Next should be creating a healthy and happy working environment. And finally, mentorship, where his teammates are growing as he or she is also growing. And there should be a stage where even if the leader is not there, the team member should be able to handle the situation properly. Now, having said all this, as per my experience and my observation, here are the three types of leadership styles that I have observed. The first one is the figure out guy. Sir, boss, the client is really upset. I need to get this file fixed. And he wants me to send it to him as soon as possible, but I know it's not going to happen. Brother, please figure it out. But sir, I am in deep trouble. What do I do? I don't know what to do. Please figure it out, dear. That is the first type. Second one, the micromanager. Well, the name is pretty self-explanatory. The micromanager is that incessant bug that keeps buzzing around and wants to see what is the update? How is this thing going? Is this finished? Is the client happy? Bro, please move away. Let me do the work. No, I want to know what is going on. I am the leader. That is the micromanager. And third one is the in-control guy. The in-control guy is your dream leader. He's the person you want to work with. But let me make things one clear. The first two, which is the figure out guy and the micromanager, they are not bad. I just portrayed them to be not good leaders, because the in control guy is a good mix of the micromanager and the figure out guy. Now, let me give you an example. This is from my personal experience. I was fortunate enough to handle a team. And now when I say team, I just meant two people, including me, there were two more people. But yeah, it's team. Let me just enjoy the glory. So, and they both were boys. Let's name them Jay and Viru. These are actual people, but I'm just going to change their name. Jay was a good employee. He was the golden boy. He was doing his work when it was supposed to be done. He was doing everything on time and he never compromised on quality. Viru, on the other hand, was a slacker. He was not best at his work. He was not someone whom you would want to work under you. Now, I should, when I'm dealing with Jay, the golden boy, it should have been a figure out guy. When Jay used to come to me, which was rarely, he used to come to me rarely, but whenever he used to come to me, I should have said, bro, just figure it out. Because mostly he used to do things on his own. And what I've noticed is people, when people are like that, they usually want to be independent. They don't want people to be on their neck, breathing down their neck and checking how things are. They want to be independent, so I should give them space. And when they come to me with a problem, at least in the beginning, I should give them a challenge. That is the challenge that they have, and I should give them that opportunity to fix themselves. Fix the challenge, fix the barrier. And that's why in the beginning, it should be figure it out. But at the same time, I should have my antenna up and I should keep an eye out on what he is doing. The second guy, Biru, who is a slacker, he is not good at his work. So I need to micromanage him. I need to figure out that, make sure that he's doing the thing or everything correctly. But that is irritating. But at the same time, Biru is also cognizant of the fact that he is not good and he wants this mentorship. And in that sense, he'll also improve. Now, when Jay and Biru were in the same room, this is the mistake that I made. I was the micromanager for both of them. This is where the in-control guy should come in. He should know how to handle the situation, but when both the scenarios are in this room, but when they're working in silos, it's easier. And the mistake that I made, that I was a micromanager with both of them. I was, in fact, the micromanager even with the golden boy. And that's the reason. So when they both are in the same room, I should gauge the situation and be the figure out guy or the micromanager, but I was not. And that's why one day, Jay, the golden boy, came to me and said, Madhu, things are not working out with me. I'm moving on to a different company. That was like a knife was stabbed right on my chest, because I really liked this kid. He was the golden boy from my lens. And he's leaving. And I was like, why? Madhu, things are not working out because you're a micromanager. And that's what opened my eyes. And I hope, and that is when I learned that these three types of leadership styles. And I hope in future, I will be the in control guy from these lessons. And I hope when you, if at all you're planning to stalk and go to my LinkedIn account and check out the people who are working in my team and ask them, they will say, Madhu is the in control guy and I love working with him. And I hope these three styles kind of throw light on leadership styles from my perspective, and it helps you all to be that in control guy as well. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Madhu. Now I would request the timer to please share the time taken by the test speaker. Arti, you're on mute.
He has taken 7 minutes.
Okay, thank you, Arti. We will now observe 5 minutes of silence for the contestants to complete their evaluation notes. A note to all the four contestants, you should mandatorily enable both your audio and video at all times in the breakout room. Okay, I repeat, you should mandatorily enable both your audio and video at all times in the breakout room. Now, I request the Zoom master to kindly move all the contestants, including both the devices for Ankit and Kalpana, and Sergeant at Arms Raj, Timer Dheeraj into the breakout room.
Okay. And Chief Judge as Chief well.
Yes. Chief Judge Atul.
Yes, they all have moved to breakout room.
Okay, so I request all present in the main room to continue to maintain silence for 5 minutes. Timer, please start your clock for 5 minutes. Okay, Zoom Master, all the contestants are moved to the breakout room, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Before we felicitate our test speaker, Toastmaster Madhu, with a digital certificate, I would like to ask you a question, Madhu. Before and after joining Toastmasters, what is your transformation?
Well, when I joined Toastmasters, I learned one thing, and that really helped, that this is a platform where I can make mistakes. And this is a platform where people are meant to make mistakes, because in the real world, that will help. And that kind of boosted my confidence. That was the springboard. And I realized when in the real world, I go with that mindset, that actually helps. The thing that was a barrier in the real world was the fact that you don't have the confidence, and it's not because you're not prepared. No matter how much ever you're prepared, it's okay to be wrong. It's okay to make mistakes. And that idea that was planted in my mind because of Toastmasters. And from that lens, it really helped me in my corporate world, the world that I just spoke about.
Thank you, Madhu. Let me share my screen. Here is a token of gratitude. Thank you so much for being the test speaker. Hope you could see my screen.
Yes, I can. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Arti, please indicate once 5 minutes has elapsed. Okay. In the meantime, is there anybody I would request one member from the audience to share his or her experience before and after joining Toastmasters in a very crisp way. Anybody from the audience? Okay, no volunteers. Yes,
hello,
Krishna.
Everybody. Hi, I'm Krishna Agrawal. There's a small difference. Before joining the Toastmasters Club, whenever I used to be in front of a group of people and that's were not known to me, I used to feel really awkward that how they are going to think about me whenever I'll be talking. If I'll be talking in the wrong sense or something. But now, because Toastmasters gives that kind of platform where nobody is going to judge you. Though we have many judges, as in today's contest, but yes, in the actual sense, nobody is going to judge you and you are free to do whatever you want to do.
Thank you so much, Krishan. Thank you so much for sharing. Okay. So let us observe a few minutes of silence.
May I also have a permission to share something?
Yes.
This is Toastmaster Josair Udaipuri from Santa Cruz Speakers Toastmasters Club. I have been a Toastmaster right from the year 2009, and I broke off in the year 2015, picking up the threads again in the year 2019. I'm sorry, just a moment. Yeah. I'm a solicitor and a lawyer by profession. I was otherwise an average or a so-so kind of a speaker, but after having coming to Toastmasters, I have become a formidable speaker and I have to do a lot of speaking in my profession because I'm a lawyer. And you have to see me to believe what Toastmasters can do to people who are sincere on the journey. Not only can you match your wits with all the others, but I can assure you that given a platform of 5,000 people, a Toastmaster will stand his own. So hats off to Toastmasters, to everybody who is on the journey anew. Great. Toastmasters is the greatest kept secret in this world. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Okay, let us observe silence. Aarti, please let us know once finally it is announced. Okay. Chief Judge DTM Atul. Sachin, is he still in the breakout room?
No. Yeah, he is still in the breakout room.
Okay, so let us wait. Sachin, can you broadcast a message? Five minutes is out and we can have our chief judge back.
Okay, sure.
Madhu, just a request, please keep your video on for all the contestants.
Okay.
Yes, to my school.
Atul, okay, both the devices I could see.
Yes, I am here. Timer 2, let us see, timer 2
yes,
has come.
Yes, I am available.
Okay.
Timer 2 also has come.
Aarti, can you please share your screen? Yes.
Yes. So, contest chair, you can advise the sergeant at arm in this room, that is Zoom master, to start the proceeding with contestant number 1.
So, in our case, contestant number 2.
And okay. You have informed that test speaker will keep his mobile video on.
Yes.
And
yes,
audio muted. Yeah.
Yes, I have mentioned. Shall we begin, Chief Judge? Atul?
Yes.
Thank you, Sachin.
Question number 2 is here.
Okay. Can you put Manas on spotlight? Okay. To do a quick audio video check, Manas, can you please repeat after me? Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Thank you. Please confirm if
can I put it down now? This paper.
Yes, it's your choice.
Thank you.
Okay. Please confirm that the timer cards are visible to you.
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. Aarti, can you please flip the cards a bit? Okay, green. Hope it is visible.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Contestant number 2, Manas. Manas, contestant number 2.
Thank you, contestant chair. Hello, everyone. One philosopher once very rightly said, life is not about the winning race. Life is about finishing the race. Toastmaster and guests, today I heard a wonderful speech from Toastmaster Madhu. First, I like to congratulate Toastmaster Madhu for become a finishator. You finish it by saying, who are you? Toastmaster Madhu, I like your storytelling methodology. You just take us through corporate world and how all the leaderships are act. So, ladies and gentlemen, when Toastmaster Madhu sold that leadership styles, he trying to put how he reached to know what type of leadership he is at this point. So when he does this, he brought us all along on a journey, as every rose has its own throne. But more importantly, that Toastmaster Madhu, when you did this, you brought yourself closer to all of us and included us in your spirit. So great job, Toastmaster Madhu. And I like your excelled at clarity, that spoken language is very clear and easily understood. And you are also that you use your work, you need to work on your eye contact, that you need to use this gaze, that the audience should feel that you need to see your audience. But I, when at these times, I connect with your story, I connect with your words, so I didn't feel, but any audience can feel that to whom you are speaking. So you just work on that, but overall, you excelled on your speech clarity, body language also you need to work it out, that when you speak that who are you, how your colleagues are told you that you are that in control guys leadership, so how you feel, so you need to show that in your body language. But yes, obviously when you called that your that other person who is not Biru, Biru is a snacker, but other guy, that how you handled that shows that you are, you know, that at that moment you are good enough. So thank you, over to you, and best of luck, Mr. Madhu. Thank you.
We will now have a minute of silence for the judges to mark their ballots. In the meantime, I would request Zoom Master to kindly broadcast a message to bring contestant number 3, Sai Kumar, to join the main room. Aarti, kindly indicate when 1 minute has elapsed.
Yes, the minute is over.
Thank you, Dheeraj. Zoom Master, thank you so much, Zoom Master, for putting Sai Kumar on spotlight. To do a quick audio video check, can you please repeat after me evaluation contest 1, 2, 3?
Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Please confirm if the timer cards are visible to you. Change of cards.
I can see a green, yellow, and thereafter the red was not displayed.
Okay, now what color do you see?
Two colors were seen. Can you flow once again?
Okay. Now?
Yes, green, yellow, red. Yes, now it's fine.
Thank you. Thank you for confirming. Are you ready?
Yes.
Contestant number 3, Sai Kumar. Sai Kumar, contestant number 3.
Leadership is a quality which has to be attained and which has to be gained by working together in a team. Today, Toastmaster Madhu painted a beautiful picture where he hooked the audience's attention with a beautiful message, strive for the action, not the position. So congratulations, Toastmaster Madhu, for such a wonderful speech. Now in 6 minutes, 30 seconds, I was totally engrossed in your speech where I tried to pick up few of your leadership qualities. The generic purpose of your speech was to inform the audience. And how you did it? By sharing the examples of your boss and manager and you. Adding different shades to your leadership quality, you shared the 3 different aspects of leadership. You also brought the conflict story of Jay and Viru, where you later on, the conflict was resolved by you. Coming to the delivery front of your speech, throughout the speech, you appeared very confident. What I like about your speech had an opening body, and you also shared illustrative examples of different leadership qualities. Now, every speech can be made better. And in Toastmasters, leaders are made. What are those one or two things which you can enhance in your leadership quality? Now, you shared the story of two characters. However, as a leader, I would have loved how you could personalize your own stories, which you said, I have the LinkedIn account. We would like to know now with one or two examples how you proved so that I can take away as a gift. Second, the conclusion I felt was little abrupt. Now, how do I mean? So you could have summarized with a strong call to action by interacting with audience. Do you still want to strive for the action or position? Something, one line specific message which I could take away as a return gift when I leave this podium. Leadership qualities, as I said, it has to be gained. And today, Toastmaster Madhu, you gave a beautiful message to summarize all the leadership quality and put it in one bucket. I would say today you informed the audience with the various aspects of leadership through personalization of two characters with a transition. Just little bit personalization of your own story and a strong call to action with one line specific message. I'm sure tomorrow, whenever I hear your speech, I will gain some leadership quality as a mentor and as a friend with you. Thank you.
We will now have 1 minute of silence for the judges to mark their ballots. In the meantime, I would request our Zoom master to kindly ask contestant number 4, Kalpana, to join the main room over a broadcast message. Kalpana, you have brought both your devices?
Yes, I am just a second.
Okay, I could see.
Yes, I'm back here.
1 minute is over.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dheeraj.
Just make sure both the devices of Kalpana are here.
Yes, Atul, they are here.
Yes, fine.
Okay. Thank you so much, Zoom Master, for putting Kalpana on spotlight. To do a quick audio video check, can you please repeat after me? Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Please confirm that the timer cards are visible to you.
Yes, they are. It's green, yellow, yeah, red.
Okay. Yes. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Contestant number 4, Kalpana. Kalpana, contestant number 4.
Good evening, contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and guests. And a very good evening to you, Madhu. Madhu, you brought into focus one particular idea that has always been in my mind, a puzzle or a jigsaw. Are leaders made or are they born? Today, you explained different styles of leadership. The main three leadership that you took made me realize that they are actually the bane in today's world, where leaders are meant to guide and create more leaders. As you opened up and brought into the focus the leadership styles, you made me realize that the crown that we wear is really very, very, very not just priceless, but heavy too. So how do we retain the human capital is what you mentioned. I really related when you spoke about the micromanagement. Without realizing, we have a tendency to micromanage everything. We want to be in control. So that part of the speech I could completely relate to. I really related to the part where you realized that you had lost someone who was could have actually been shapen up and sparkled up as a diamond, but you lost him because of your micromanagement leadership style. And you wanted to now correct yourself, change yourself is what takes us on the path of a leadership or on the path of a leader that I could relate to. And that opened my eyes because it was like a bullet point that hit me on my psyche of what I should do if I wanted to be a leader. When I focused on the speech that you spoke about, if the same things were spoken with equal energy, enthusiasm, emotions, and voice modulations, like the pain you felt when you realized that your friend said it is leaving because of your micromanagement leadership style, it should have hit you like a swamp. You should have said, I felt the pain. I realized what I did was wrong. Such emotions only enrich your speech. I would like to really like to summarize the speech of yours, leadership qualities that are needed in today's world, how to retain the human capital in today's world or even human relations, because micromanagement is done in all regions and we need and force ourselves to be in control, thinking that is what makes a leader. I wish you had also said more about leadership styles. There are many leadership styles, like autocratic leadership styles. There are leadership styles that are democratic. And what are the leadership styles that are needed right now? Had you ended on that note, that leaders should make leaders. That means we should give space, personal space for people to develop. So in summary, add energy, voice modulation, connect your speech well, make the commitment very strong. Thank you. Over to you.
We will now have a minute of silence for the judges to mark their ballots. In the meantime, I would request our Zoom master to broadcast a message to kindly ask contestant number 5, Ankit, to join the main room. Timer, please indicate when 1 minute has elapsed. Aarti, do you have any trouble? Yes, Aarti.
Okay, it was muted, so I was not able to.
Okay, hope you have your timer cards ready, right?
Yes.
Okay, please indicate when 1 minute is finished.
So Raj should also be here because he is the last contestant, right? Raj is there?
Yes, Raj is there.
1 minute is over.
1 minute over.
Zoom master, thank you so much for putting Ankit on spotlight. To do a quick audio video check, can you please repeat after me? Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3. Ankit?
Evaluation contest 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Please confirm that the timer cards are visible to you.
Yes, the timer cards are visible to me.
Contestant number 5, Ankit. Ankit, contestant number 5.
Leadership is not about a title or designation. It's about creating impact, inspiring, and influencing people. Toastmaster of the day, contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and my target speaker, Madhu. In your 7-minute speech, Toastmaster Madhu, you gave a well informative and impactful speech on leadership. What I loved about your speech, Toastmaster Madhu, was that you started with a smile. And a smile is a curve which puts everything straight. And I was connected with your speech at that moment. I loved the structure of your speech, Toastmaster Madhu. You went straight to the point and talked about leadership. Then you gave what are the different types of leadership and you told about the objectives. The structure was well defined. The best part about your speech was personal stories. Stories sell and stories connect with the people very well. And you had personal story in your speech, Toastmaster Madhu. You talked about the story of your own journey as a leader with your two, Jai and Viru. And I was connected with your speech because I also could associate my leadership journey with that. The icing on the cake was your hand gestures. You had good hand gestures, which was showing that you're a confident speaker. When you were speaking at one point and the other, your hand gestures are moving. And that was showing that you're a confident speaker. Overall, a beautiful speech, which had all the elements that are required for a good speech. But every beautiful rose has some thorns, Toastmaster Madhu. And I have three suggestions which for your beautiful speech. First is your title. Your title was Striving for Action, Not for Position. I felt for a speech which was on leadership, your title could have been more associated with leadership. That could have given us some inclination about what you are going to talk about. For example, you could have said, my journey with leadership. That would have given us some aspect about what you're going to talk about. The second aspect that I felt you could have done better was the character building. You had three aspects of leadership in your speech. That was the figure out guy, the micromanager, and the dream leader. Why not give a description of those people to make us associated maybe with our managers? The figure out guy, that guy who was bald and is always there around in your office. The micromanager will always be behind you, standing there. Have you felt that? That will connect the audience better in terms of the speech. The third part that I felt you could have done better was your opening. Attention grabbing opening is something that connects the audience and gets the attention of the audience. But you started directly talking about leadership. Maybe a quote, maybe something about leadership, maybe a hand gesture, or even maybe us connecting with the audience in terms of audience interaction could have made that aspect better. That is the opening. Overall, a beautiful speech which had structure, personal stories, and hand gestures. Just working on your character building, attention grabbing, and the title, I believe your speech would have been beautiful. But with these points, Toastmaster Madhu, you can mold your beautiful speech into a beautiful rose without any thorns. Thank you, and over to you, Contest Chair.
We will now maintain 3 minutes of silence for the judges to total their scores and hand them over to the ballot counters.
Yeah. And the two timers, please send your timing report to me 1-to-1 on WhatsApp.
One minute.
No, it's 3 minutes, Arti. 3 minutes.
I have to move the slide to the last one. Last slide.
Before that.
That's the left key.
Arki, no problem. You can let me know once 3 minutes have passed.
I am in process of receiving the judges' ballots.
Okay. Then. Yeah, you can confirm. Yeah, once you confirm, we will move you to the
report. Sir, timer 2 has sent the report.
I am also seeing.
Thank you, Dheeraj. Chief Judge Atul, kindly confirm once we can.
No, some judges have not done the right way, so please wait.
Okay, fine.
See, you can still move us out. I can always have one-to-one with judges.
Okay.
They might be feeling disturbed while they are here, but we have no choice. Some judges have not written their name. So if you have other things to do, yes, move me and the 3 tally counters to the breakout room. Judges may be here, but some of the judges have not done correctly. So move us out.
Sachin, can you facilitate that?
Yes, done.
Okay. You could see Atul still here.
Yeah, they are joining.
Okay.
Tally counter to Sandeep, please join the breakout room.
All have been moved, Sachin?
No, tally counter 2 has not been moved yet. Tally counter 2, Sandeep.
Yes. Can you share me again the room?
Yes, he has moved to breakout room. Atul has 2 devices, so only 1 have been moved to breakout room.
Okay. So shall we proceed? I hope, I presume he is active in the other device. Okay. I would now like to invite all the evaluation speech contestants to come forward in their speaking order to receive their digital certificates of participation. Toastmaster Manas.
minutes.
Okay. You have mentioned about a question, a statement, help selflessly, whole universe will help you endlessly. Can you give a hint what inspired you for this thought? Manas?
Yes, condition there. Am I audible and visual?
Yes, yes, Manas.
Yeah, thank you. Actually, I believe that suppose if you are helping to others, then you will get the help. So because every person born in this came into this world without nothing on their own, and they would not go with a handful of their hand. So whatever their earnings, those they need to live at this planet only. So they will take only their name only. So here my feeling is that I always tell that help selflessly, without expecting anything, just help to the needy, so that universe, that God is there, if we are believing that, he will help to you endless, without any limitlessly. Thank you, Gandhi there.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Manas. So here is a token of gratitude. Thank you so much for participating in the evaluation speech contest. All the best. Next, I would like to call Toastmaster Sai Kumar. Sai Kumar.
Hello. Yeah.
Hey, hi, Sai. You have written pets are humanizing. Okay, so do you have any pets, or what is your take on this?
No. So, I don't have any pets in my home, but whenever I see any street dog or pets suffering from any kind of thing or disease, or they are not able to get some kind of food, I always, with my friend, take them to the veterinary doctor and give them treatment and put them in a secure place and hand over to, there are many units which take care of pets and all. So pets are a humanizing means, and also I use this same principle in my office also, where I did one event where I informed all the associates who have pets, dogs, kittens in their home, take care, because they are also a part of your family. So I feel pets are humanizing.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Sai Kumar, for sharing your thoughts. And here is, as a token of gratitude, please find the certificate of participation, digital certificate. Thank you so much for participating.
Thank you.
All the best. And next, I would like to call Toastmaster Kalpana to the virtual stage.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you and see you. You have written, father inspires you the most. You know, I always feel fathers are least spoken, though they do so much. Okay, always mothers are spoken. About them only we speak a lot. So can you please share any very crisp incident that actually, because of which you always feel father is the most inspiring person?
Yes. Actually, my father, as you mentioned, was a very quiet but a very strong force behind all of us. You know, let me tell you a very small incident that actually happened while we were in Kerala, and we still are in Kerala actually, and we have our coconut business over there. I had that ego and pride, and was really a very bad child, you know, who felt no little of myself. On a very hot sunny afternoon, you know, a laborer came to my house, just knocked at the gate. I happened to open it, and I told him very arrogantly, you know, when he asked for my father, that he's sleeping, come any other time you want. Coincidentally, my father was in the terrace and he watched the whole scene. He stopped me right there, called that laborer back, spoke to him, and after the laborer went, he said, when a man comes to you in the blazing hot sun, there has got to be something important. You have to look at what the man has got to say and not the status of that person. That was a lesson I have learned so well in my life, and I actually implemented as far as possible that humbleness is a great pie. It's better to eat the humble pie always. Thanks. That's why father is my inspiration.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kalpana. And indeed, fathers are truly inspiring. This is a token of gratitude for, and thank you so much for participating. All the best, Kalpana.
Thank you.
Next, I would like to invite our contestant number 5, Ankit, to the virtual podium, please.
Hi, Subbu.
Hey, hi, Ankit. You have written, seeing a person, means you have guided or assisted in any way, achieve whenever he or she achieves success, that inspires you the most. What is the highest success that you feel you have achieved through this? Or can you refer, make any reference?
Sure. So, I come from a, so I'll give you the background of this. At my initial years, let me talk about Toastmasters itself. When I joined Toastmasters, there were a lot of mentors, a lot of people that I had who supported me or guided me in terms of my journey. And that's the reason I believe it's a, I've come at a stage where I may have, I'm still improving, but I may have learned some things. And I want to impart that back to everyone who are present around me, because I have been impacted by my mentors. And that's the reason I feel that if I'm able to at least help someone out in their leadership or their communication journey, I would have achieved something. In terms of the highest thing that I've achieved is one of my mentees had won the division level at an international speech contest. So that was a very motivating thing for me. And she had actually mentioned my name in the interview or when that was asked. So it was just a small kind of a satisfaction that at least I could help her in some way in her journey. So that brings about an inspiration, a smile on my face. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ankit, for sharing. Here is a token of gratitude, a certificate of participation. Thank you so much for participating and all the best. Hereby, I officially adjourn this evaluation speech contest. Thank you so much for being a fabulous audience. I hope you enjoyed the contest as much as I enjoyed the contest. I would like to thank all the contestants and the contest officials for an excellent job, and you and all our wonderful audience for being so appreciative. I now hand over the control to our Toastmaster Vriddhi, who would be handing over the certificates and conducting the interviews for the humorous speech contestants. Over to Toastmaster Vriddhi.
Thank you so much, Contest Chair Subramaniam. Don't worry, humorous speech contestants, we haven't forgotten you. Folk interviews are done. We still have some more to go. Right? So, Zoom Master, can we please spotlight contestant number 1, Dheeraj Singh? Yes, he's spotlighted. I'm going to ask him to unmute. He does not need to stay on mute anymore. Hi, Dheeraj.
Hi, ma'am.
Hi, ma'am. No. Please. Okay, so I read your contestant profile and you say that you like to learn new things. So yes. Can you share something new that you've learned over this weekend?
This weekend, what I learned new? Okay, then I have to think about. Yes, I learned a lot of things about my personality. I am also, I have given a chance to participate in Gurukul 2.0. So from there, we get to know that what are the different personalities and what is my personality. So I got to know that I am a very dominant personality. I need to reduce my dominance over the other people. So this is the one thing, and I liked it. And there are how to handle different personality people, that some are very kind, some are work-oriented, some are people-oriented. So how to handle them. This is the one thing that I learned on Saturday. Yeah, this is amazing.
That's amazing. I think all of us can take away that learning, that in case we're too dominant, we can mild it down. If we give in too easily, we can, ramp up our game. Please accept this token of appreciation for having participated in the humorous speech contest. All the very best, Dheeraj.
Thank you.
Can we now please spotlight contestant number 2? Manas. Okay, I'm asking you to unmute.
Yeah, hi, Bibi.
I know Subbu already conducted an interview for you, but just quickly, I'd like to know, how is your experience with both the contests?
Oh, it's a tremendous day. Actually, this is my first contest, and I do not like to miss anything. So last moment also, really, I asked Ankit to not to, I just want to quit.
But he is the only person who, his word actually pushed me to participate. So I just, yesterday night only, I just forward him that my speech to have a look.
So that way we can basically take away, Toastmaster Sai Kumar's words that it's never too late. You can still prepare, even if you have some, very little time left. So right, please accept this token of appreciation for having participated at the Hubris Speech Contest. All the very best for the results.
Thank you.
So, Master, can we please spotlight contestant number 3 of the Hubris Speech Contest? Sai Kumar.
Hello, Riti.
I'm posing the same question to you. How is it participating in both the contests on the same day?
No, for me, I will tell you, for the first time I'm participating in humorous contest after being 5 to 6 years in Toastmasters. So this is a very different experience in virtual world. I'm a serious guy, so I don't know to generate humor. So I was not participating till 5 years now. So even my mentor and my other colleagues said, no, you should participate, try to inculcate and add some tinge of humor, slowly and slowly will improve. So this was my beautiful experience in participating first time in humorous. And an evaluation is concerned, I participate in every season. So that was I say every evaluation contest is also a learning experience where I get to know and how other speakers evaluate the speech. Thank you.
Wonderful. Please accept this token of appreciation for having participated in the Humorous Speech Contest. All the very best, Sai Kumar.
Thank you.
Master, may we please spotlight question number 4, Kalpana.
I would first like to bring to notice that the name is wrong. I'm Kalpana Kishore, K-I-S-H-O-R.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry about this. I will definitely change it and send it back to you.
Okay, no problem at all.
Okay, that isn't something. Oh, I get it. Name and identity. That's exactly why you picked it up. I'm very sorry about that. But how has the weekend been? I know that you have not keeping pretty well last evening. So how are you feeling now?
Touch wood, good, because I have had a corrective eye surgery and too much of exposure to the, this is laptop as well as mobile, as well as a short trip to Udaipur left me literally with burning eyes and sore eyes. So yesterday, I think that my doctor advised me a complete fasting from all electronic devices so that I could at least participate today. So I think that was the reason, but thank God I've participated with my eyes.
We're very glad that you took the words of your doctor very seriously.
Yes.
Please accept this token of appreciation for having contested in the Humorous Speech Contest. All the very best, Kalpana.
Thank you, Riti.
Can we please spotlight contestant number 5? Hi, Arti.
Hello, Riti.
Arti, I saw that you've written that you like watching, listening to music and watching motivational videos. So which is your favorite song and what could, what comes to your mind for this amazing weekend that we've had? Do line ho jaye, jo bhi aapko pasand ho.
क्या खूब लगती हो बड़ी सुंदर दिखती हो तुम जान से प्यारी हो तुम जान हमारी हो कहते रहो अच्छा लगता है जीवन का हर सपना अब सच्चा लगता है ओ क्या खूब लगती हो बड़ी सुंदर दिखती हो.
That was beautiful, Arti. Thank you so much for that. Please accept this token of appreciation for having participated in the Humorous Speech Contest. All the very best for the results.
Thank you.
Master, may we please spotlight contestant number 6, Shreya. Hi, Shreya.
Hello.
So which is the latest book you read, Shreya? I see journaling, singing, reading, a lot of your interests. So which is the latest book you read? The Power of Now.
Yes.
It's a pretty strong title, I must say.
Yes, I love reading self-help books. They are helping me now in this journey of MBA.
Wonderful, wonderful, Shreya. Please accept this token of appreciation for having contested in the humorous speech contest. All the very best.
Thank you.
Now, last but not the least, can we please spotlight contestant number 8, Pranjali. Hi, Pranjali.
Hello.
How was your experience with having participated? Was it a new challenge that you had to accept?
Yes, Vriti. Actually, it was a challenge. As told by somebody, I am also not very humorous type of character. And it is difficult for me to laugh at the jokes. And today I had to make laugh people. So it was really a challenge. I don't know how I have taken it up. And you all are the best judge for it. I don't know. But it was really challenging. And this was my first contest, actually. I have just started my journey. So in the first milestone itself, I received this challenge. So I'm so happy that I am able to go up to the mark, at least participate and have my own satisfaction.
Wonderful, actually. Amazing. Please accept this token of appreciation for having participated in the humorous speech contest. All the very best.
Thank you.
And with that, I think I'm on the spotlight now. So I've thoroughly enjoyed being the contest chair today. Hearing this humorous speeches and wonderful enthusiasm of the contestants have left me energized for the rest of the weekend for sure. A big thank you to the contest officials for an excellent job done and the wonderful audience for being so appreciative. I'm going to hold back the results and I'm going to hand over the virtual stage to our Chief Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Raj, for the felicitation of the other role players. Over to you, Chief Sergeant.
Thank you, Contest Chair Riti. Thank you so much. I will request Toastmaster Sachin to share screen for felicitating all the role players who has played so significant role today in successfully conducting this contest. Sachin.
Sure, Raj. Is it visible?
Yes. So hi, Deepa. Let's start from Chief Judge for Humorous Speech Contest, Toastmaster Deepa. Thank you so much, Deepa, for your all contribution which you did for conducting this contest very smoothly, for all your effort, for all your input, for everything you did, Toastmaster Deepa. Congratulations. And thank you so much. Kindly accept the certificate of appreciations for all your effort, for all your inputs you did for this club contest. Thank you so much, Deepa.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Raj.
Next is Chief Judge of Evaluation Speech Contest, Distinguished Toastmaster Atul Srivastava. Yes, managing a Evaluation Speech Contest, a tough task. And yes, he has to go through a lot of challenges to get these things done very smoothly. Congratulations, Toastmaster Atul, for successfully conducting Evaluation Speech Contest for this club. Thank you so much for all your effort, for all your input you did for this contest to make this successful. Kindly accept this certificate of appreciation, Toastmaster Atul.
Thank you. Thank you, Area Director. Raj, thank you very much.
Thank you, Atul. Next is, yes. So, Women of Humorous Speech Contest, Toastmaster Riti Agrawal, for making this segment truly humorous from every aspect. Congratulations, Toastmaster Riti, and thank you so much for making this humorous speech contest so live, so just like you. You did very well, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Raj.
And contest chair for Evaluation Speech Contest, Distinguished Toastmaster Subramanyam Srinivasan. Thank you so much for everything you did as a contest chair for making this contest, the evolutionary speech contest, successful. Kindly accept this certificate of appreciation, distinguished Toastmaster Subramanian.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Raj. Thank you.
Toastmaster Sachin, he has a lot of responsibilities for making this contest a great success. He must be playing multiple roles in the backend. Thank you so much, Sachin, for handling the two master role for both the contest so well, so well. Thank you so much, Sachin.
Thank you so much, Raj. Thank you.
Next is Shovit Parasam as timer for humorous speech contest. Timer role is very critical. We have to monitor very precisely every second of the contestant timing. Thank you so much, Shovit, for playing your role very precisely. Congratulations. Kindly accept the certificate for appreciation for you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you, Shovit. Ankit, distinguished Toastmaster Ankit, thank you so much for playing a timer 2 for humorous speech contest. Thank you so much, Ankit. Kindly accept certificate of appreciation for that.
Thank you, Raj.
Next. Yes, Toastmaster Aarti, timer for evolution speech contest. Yes. Timer role is very crucial, very critical. We have to take care of a lot of things to get precise in every aspect, mostly in evaluation speech contest. Thank you so much, Aarti, for your contribution. Kindly accept this certificate of appreciation for your significant contribution to the contest.
Thank you.
Next, Sachin. Dheeraj, yes. Thank you so much, Dheeraj, and congratulations for being a timer in evolution speech contest. You were in breakout room also with me. Really, you did very well, very awesome. Thank you so much. Kindly accept this certificate of appreciation for you.
Thank you, Raj.
Next, Sachin. Telecounter Toastmaster Maitri, I'm not sure whether I'm saying the name rightly, but thank you so much. As a telecounter, it's a great responsibility to tally all the scores for deciding winner of the contest. Thank you so much for your contribution. Thank you. Kindly accept certificate of appreciation for you.
Thank you, Raj. Thank you.
Next, Sachin. Sandeep. Sandeep, truly thanks for your contribution as tally counter for making this contest a great success and giving your significant contribution. Kindly accept certificate of appreciation, Toastmaster Sandeep.
Thank you, Toastmaster Raj. Thank you.
Next, Sachin. Yes. Again, another tally counter, Toastmaster Karthik Krishnan. Thank you so much for all significant contribution you made as tally counter for determining the results for this contest. Kindly accept certificate of appreciation, Toastmaster Karthik.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Sachin?
Yeah, that's it, I think.
Okay. So thank you so much, everyone. Now I pass control back to Vice President Education of the Club, Toastmaster Sachin.
Thank you so much, Raj. You have done your Chiefs role brilliantly, I must say. And you have taken the role at the last moment. So it is just a token of appreciation from our club side. Congratulations. And this is a certificate of appreciation for that. Thank you so much, Raj, for being Chiefs and doing your role perfectly. Thank you.
Thank you, Sachin. Thank you.
Yeah, now I will hand over the stage back to Vrithi.
Thank you, Sachin. I can still see your appreciation cards. Wonderful. I think it's that time of the evening that we have all been eagerly waiting for. Please let me know if my screen comes up. Does this a certificate of participation? I'm sorry, no, I'm announcing the winners. So at third place for the humorous speech contest, we have Toastmaster Dheeraj Singh. Congratulations, Toastmaster Dheeraj.
Thank you.
On having won the second place, we have Toastmaster Sai Kumar Iyer. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Any guesses for the first place? There's going to be some suspense. Come on. Sorry, I heard a name.
Toastmaster Kalpana.
Okay. Yeah, you're right, RTG. First place goes to Toastmaster Kalpana. Toastmaster Kalpana Kishore will be representing the Speakers Community Toastmasters Club at the area level contest to be conducted on 26 September. Congratulations, Toastmaster Kalpana.
Thank you. I was like terrified and nervous because all of them did well. All of them, including Dheera, Sai, even Pranjali with the topic of hers. And I'm overwhelmed. Thank you.
Wonderful. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
And that's it from my side. I now pass on the stage to our contest chair from the evaluation speech contest, distinguished Toastmaster Subramanian. Over to you.
I'm audible.
Okay.
Thank you so much. I would like to present now the contest results for evaluation speech contest. I would like to congratulate all the contestants for competing, and I am very happy to announce that there were no disqualifications on the basis of time. So our third place winner is Sai Kumar Iyer. Hello. I'm audible, right?
Yes.
You're audible. Please go ahead.
The second place winner is Kalpana Kishore. Congratulations. The winner of the evaluation speech contest of the Speakers Community Toastmasters Club, who would be representing this club at the Area M3 contest, which is scheduled on 26th of September 2021, is Ankit Das Gupta. Congratulations to all the winners, and I thoroughly enjoyed the session. Thank you so much for having me as the contest chair, and thank you so much, distinguished Toastmaster Atul Srivastava, for guiding us throughout, and all the members, senior members like Ankit and other members who have been guiding us throughout. Thank you so much for being wonderful audience as well. Over to Sachin. Okay, Vridhi.
Can you please turn on our cameras and capture this moment? It's been a wonderful evening.
Yes, everyone, please turn on cameras. My God, it is going out of the frame. Great. Say tally counters, please turn on the cameras. Thank you. Tally counter to Sandeep. SHEs.
Yes.
Yeah, done.
Thank you
so much, everyone.
I think we were saying something.
We can, I think, stop the recording now. So I think we are. So,
yeah. No, I was just saying bye everyone. Congratulations to all the winners. Wonderful job as a team. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Atul. Thank you for being a part of it, and thank you for the support.
Thank you, everyone. See you again very soon. Bye, everyone. And congratulations to all the winners.
Thank you. I would request the guests to please be present, because we haven't had a chance to introduce the guests. So just a moment before that, if you can just have a, if you can stop the spotlight.